Because of an interface fire reported at about 3 o'clock Sunday afternoon, some areas of the central Okanagan are now under a state of emergency, including Trepanier, which is just above Peachland. It's about 7 o'clock now on Sunday evening, and in about an hour, air support will be retiring.
Fire started up on the Kokahela connector this afternoon, up around the turn off to the Trepanier Valley area, which was outside of our area. We sent some crews up there, and forestry sent some crews. The winds were very, very strong in that area, coming down the canyon, blew the fire down into our area, and it just kept going until, as you can see it now, the wind has died down a little bit, which is in our favor, but we have lost a number of structures, and there's a lot of forest areas and timber areas that have been consumed as well.
This is clearly a wind-driven fire, very substantial winds driving the fire along down towards the lake. Very tough to stay ahead of, spotting ahead of itself several hundred meters, a very difficult fire to fight.
We set up a command post on Highway 97C so that we could direct the operations from here. We have seven divisions there and an operations chief on the ground, and we have resources from West Kelowna, from Kelowna, from Ellison.
What's going to happen once the air support retires, which will be at dark?
Well, at this point, the air tankers already had to back off due to visibility issues. We'll utilize whatever light and good visibility we can to drop with the air with the remaining bucket ships, the helicopters. And then we'll just use our manpower through the night with water tenders, working off hydrants, hoses, and just do our best to contain wherever we can.
It's heavily populated down there. That's why it's such a worry, and there's a lot of pine trees and forested areas as well. So it's really tough to get it to stop anything when the wind's blowing so hard.
Must be tough for you guys when you look over there and see that there are structures going up.
Yeah, this is an awful experience for any of the firefighters. We don't like fires like this. It's very tough to be playing catch up the whole time and having it bounce past your lines and that sort of thing. So yeah, difficult fire for us for sure. It's really tough at this point with the visibility and the smoke to estimate a size. I'll wait till I get my helicopter, give me a good view on that. It's just been growing so rapidly too.
What is the night kind of shaping up for you guys? Do you have any idea?
We'll have to have patrols on overnight. And we'll keep patrols on overnight just to keep everything from spreading, help put out spot fires, and then be back at it in the morning again.
They got the dozer guards going to start going in behind the homes over there, and then they'll link up the 40 guys for the unit crews.
Traffic disruptions during the state of emergency are imminent. For more information on the status of the Okanagan Connector, Highway 97C, visit the Drive BC website. As new information on evacuation alerts and orders develop, that information will be available on the Regional District's Emergency Program website. And call 1-877-569-8490 for public inquiries. Residents within the evacuation area are asked to report to the Emergency Support Service Reception Center at the West Bank Lions Hall, 2466 Main Street in West Kelowna. A second Emergency Support Services Reception Center is open for residents needing assistance and having to drive south from Peachland at the Summerland Arena and Curling Club, 8820 Jubilee Road. The Kelowna Riding Club is open to receive evacuated and rescued horses from the Peachland Fire at 3745 Gordon Drive.